you this morning, King of all the glory. We thank you for blessing us with life. We thank you that you are in good health, and that's the reason we made into this house that is called by your name. We worship you and we honor you, O God, for giving us an opportunity to feed from your table this morning. It's my humble prayer, O God, that you are going to minister to each and every one of us, O God, such that we will not regret as to why we came into this house, O God. I pray that your Holy Spirit may take charge. I pray that your Holy Spirit may dwell each and every one of us, O God, and speak to us with a voice that we are able to understand. And also, O God, we humble before thee, God, pray that if there is any obstacle, anything that can stop your move this morning, on behalf of the congregation, I want to repent of all our known and unknown sins, O God. Forgive our wrongdoings, King of all the glory, and help us to be right with you, O God. Use me as a vessel for your own glory, and this is our prayer of faith in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. Please join with me in singing this chorus that I feel is blessing my soul this morning. The blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh,
you are not in
control. And this morning, the Bible is so clear. And the Bible is telling us that, awake, you who sleep, arise from the dead, and Christ will give you life. When I think about somebody who is asleep, I was going through the Bible and I was looking at this word sleep, and it's mentioned over 103 times, and it is mentioned good things about sleep, it's mentioned terrible things about sleep, and I want to touch but a few. Sleep is being mentioned for the first time in the Bible from the book of Genesis, chapter 2, verse number 21. This is when God made sure that Adam was in a deep sleep before he removed one of his ribs to make him a helper. So that was good sleep. In 1990, I happened to be hospitalized, Nanikalafa Hospital, and I went under an operation for about 3 years, for about 3 hours, and I remember I didn't know what was going on, but I know I had some family members, and Alice was my fiancée then, and so she came to see me, and they had to wait until I awake from my sleep. Many times, people who undergo operations don't even wake up, because when that injection has been induced in one, it's not necessarily that they will wake up, because they are as dead. And I was dead, but by the mercies of God, I came back to life. But I didn't know what took place. But the doctor operated on me. But I thank God today I am still serving this God because He is still faithful. I want to say that sleep is good, but also sleep is dangerous. Sleep is equally dangerous. I am talking about physical sleep. It's good because it helps us to maintain our good health. But it's equally dangerous because when we sleep, anything can take place which is beyond our control. The Bible says that Samson, a mighty, strong man of God, in Judges chapter 16, verse number 19, that he had a friend called Delilah, and Delilah made sure that he's going to Akamdangalia, Kamwambia, come and sleep on my thighs. And Samson akalala pale. And remember, Samson was a son of Manoah. And Manoah was a servant of God, and they had waited upon God for a long time before they were married together with his wife. And he had waited upon God. And one day, an angel of the Lord came and confirmed to them, and the angel told them, you will receive a son. They had waited, they were barren. And thank God, because Samson was born out of a couple that had waited upon God. So Samson was an answered prayer. But this time now, he slept. And after sleeping, the power that was within him was taken away by the evil one. Sleep is good and dangerous. There's also a certain young man in the book of Acts, chapter 20, verse 7 to 12, Eutychus. Eutychus was a young man, and he was among the members of the congregation as well this morning. And he went to listen to a servant of God called Paul. Paul was ministering his last he was living. And since everyone knew who Paul was, they wanted to hear his last message. And the Bible says that they were gathered, so many of them, and they were some stairs. I don't know how he was reaching them, because there were none of these microphones then. But somehow, they were able, Paul was able to communicate to all of them. And so there was this young man who sat beside the window on the third floor, and he was keen listening to Paul. But somehow he was carried away and he slept. And the Bible says that he fell from the third floor and died. But Paul went to him and prayed for this guy called Eutychus, and he came back to life. Eutychus slept physical sleep, but something would happen because he gave back his life. He slept, but in the right place. He wanted to hear the good news, but somehow he slept. And it was okay, because he was in the right place. And God brought him back to life. The dangers of sleep is the danger of sleep is that terrible things can happen. We just see Samson lost the power that was within him. And the Bible says in the book of Psalms 13, verse number 3, David is asking God, and he's telling God, "Consider and hear me, O Lord, my God. Enlighten my eyes, lest I sleep the sleep of death." David is pleading with God that he wants his eyes to remain enlightened, because he does not want to sleep the sleep of death. This morning, I am here to tell you and to remind us that when we sleep, we automatically fall away from the worship community. When we spiritually go to sleep, we fall away from the worshiping community. Eutychus, after he dropped dead, he was no longer enjoying the sermon that was ongoing from Paul, because he was no more. He was already separated from the entire worship team. I need to talk about spiritual sleep. When we sleep spiritually, we are already excommunicated. We have been cut off from the true worshippers. How do we lose? How do we go the spiritual sleep? How do we find ourselves there? The minute you fail to pray, brethren, we lose it. We start dozing. The minute you miss prayers, unaanza kusinzia. Pole pole, kusinzia haujalala. Bado unaweza jua what is happening, though you are like half asleep. You continue failing to pray, you will also miss the word of God, because you don't have time to read the word of God. When you don't pray, you don't read the word of God, you start enjoying spiritual sleep. And when that continues, you are completely cut off from the true worshippers. And what happens? What happens is that you don't pray, you don't read the word of God, so you are cut off. So even God to you is not going. And that's how many Christians are falling asleep spiritually, because they have prioritized other things and they forgot prayers, they forgot to read the word of God, and number three, they forgot fellowship with fellowshipping with brethren, and they feel that they are okay, they are comfortable, and they are at peace with their own self. And that's how you see somebody who was so strong, who was a true Christian, who could have actually do so much in the house of God, they are no more in the house of God. And others are still in the house of God, but they are spiritually asleep. They no longer recognize this God. And that's why you find somebody in awkward places. You'll find somebody who still bears a testimony of Dumbo. And you'll find somebody seated in a nightclub thinking that nobody can see them. Let me tell you that somebody is okay but spiritually asleep. That's why you find some people obeying the flesh. Why? Because they are asleep. Wamesha kuwa cut off. They are no longer in the true Christian worship community. They are already gone. Let me tell you, when you are spiritually dead or asleep, because it is equal and it is as good as being dead, you are vulnerable. You can do anything. Your flesh can lead you anywhere. Your tongue can say anything. You can even curse God. You can do anything. But the Bible this morning, God is merciful to each and every one of us, and He is asking us to wake up from our slumber. We wake up from not having some sweet moment with your Maker. You wake up from not reading the word of God. You wake up from not attending brethren's fellowship. I am not talking about those fellowship that you will fellowship and at the end of the fellowship, I am not talking about those fellowship. I am talking about the fellowship of true worshippers who will seek God, who will listen to the Holy Spirit of God. Like in the Acts chapter 13, you see serious men of God there. They are gathered together, prophets, teachers of the law, and the Holy Spirit is addressing them, and He's telling them, can you set apart for me two gentlemen, Saul and Barnabas, for the task ahead? Brethren that will pray until God reveals Himself, speaks and responds to their cry. That is the kind of a fellowship I am talking about. There is danger when we are spiritually asleep. But there is hope this morning. There is hope this morning. Genesis chapter 39, verse number 9. We find a story of somebody who was spiritually alert. He was physically alert and spiritually awake. This man is called Joseph. And the Bible says that there was that wife of Potiphar, and he wanted to lie with Joseph. He wanted to go to bed with Joseph, but Joseph was awake. Joseph was alert. And Joseph looked at this woman and he told her, I have authority over everything in this house apart from you, the wife of my master. I have powers to do anything, but not you. And let me tell you, the Bible continues to say that Joseph addressed this woman without fear, and he told her, I cannot do such wickedness. I cannot do such great wickedness. And sin, not against her, not against the beef master. But the Bible put it so clear, and it is on your screen. I cannot do such wicked thing and sin against God. Brethren, when we enjoy
that you are just sinning against maybe your partner or your friends, but I'm telling you, you are sinning against God. Joseph purposed within him to remain alert and awake no matter what. Hata kama nguo zilibaki ndani, Joseph ran na akasema, I will remain a young man of integrity. It doesn't matter what will befall on me. I'm sure Joseph would have compromised and said, nobody is watching on me. Nobody has seen me. They are not other workers around. It's only me and her. And so it's just about, it's just a matter of 5 minutes, and I close the chapter. Wapendwa, God is watching. You may come to the church and pretend to be a good Christian and do so many things in the church. But when you are spiritually asleep, brothers, we are sinning against God. Let us purpose to do good. Let us purpose to wake up. Because when we arise from our sleep, Jesus is ready to hold our hands and to restore us from the dead. And we will live again because he is a good God and a faithful God. Joseph is a very good example. He said, fine, if I do this thing and maybe my master come to realize, I will be fired. Maybe he could say so many things, but I want to tell you, Joseph overlooked all that and he said, his fear is not on any one of you, but upon his maker, God. Wapendwa, chochote, tunafanya. Tutambue kwamba, the eye of the Lord is watching. Hizo nyumba unaendaga, unaingia. Our vicar may not see you, but God is watching over you. Hizo mikutano unaendaga, ambazo haziletei Mungu sifa, God is watching. Hawa watu unatembelea kutafuta msaada, apart from seeking help from the Almighty God, God is watching. When you practice witchcraft and the kind, najua kuna watu na biashara zao zimejaa hirizi, their powers that protect their businesses, God is watching. There are families that are suffering because of one of them is not faithful to God. God is watching. Ukumbuke, you are not sinning against your partner. You are not sinning against the community. We are sinning against God. May the Lord have mercy upon us. That when he looks at us as Emmanuel, members of congregation, they are just good, they love me. When they worship me, it's not just another Sunday, it's not just a routine. I thank God because this morning we did things the way we normally don't do them. We began the service direct to the Holy Communion. It is not usual, but it is important sometimes to change things. Because sometimes we are used to routine. Kwa hivyo takuja kama kufika wakati wa worship, najua kuna watu wanasimama hapa, tutarukaruka, tutafukuza baridi. I hear some people say, simameni kufukuza baridi. I hate to hear such sentiments. We are here to worship God, sio kufukuza baridi. Praise the Lord. When we worship God, are we giving true worship? Because God is watching. God is watching.